like all treatments for cancer, one has to analyze the benefits of the treatment and the risks and toxicity of the treatment. In the case of the aromatase inhibitors, they have been found to be slightly better than tamoxifen in decreasing the risk of local and systemic recurrence after breast cancer. The more ominous the breast cancer, the more likely is one to get a benefit from either tamoxifen or an aromatase inhibitor. So that the indication is based on the nature of the breast cancer, with larger tumors or node-positive tumors having more benefit, and then obviously the toxicity can only be assessed in each individual patient. At some level, if the patient has a terrible time with an aromatase inhibitor, one would certainly not want to expose the patient to that level of toxicity for 5 years and would either switch to another aromatase inhibitor or more likely switch to tamoxifen, which is only slightly less beneficial than the aromatase inhibitor. So the decision is based on, number one, the characteristics of the cancer, and number two, the individual patient's level of toxicity. Most patients on an aromatase inhibitor can take 5 years without a whole lot of trouble, mostly the problems being nuisance level arthralgias or joint pain and muscle pain. But about 5 or 10% of women have enough trouble on the aromatase inhibitors that one might go to another drug such as tamoxifen.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.